Throughout the contest and the administration of both schools request the same all fans. The official society was working with an extensive requirement, simply by way of one point two changing, and they have been assigned based upon the process approved by the OHSA and Sports for Americans. The officials for tonight's game, the Juan Hammonds, Nicole DiGiulio, Brittany Young, and Ashley Graves. We have all the privilege of our guests, the Central Boston High School, all made for us to reflect the effort each has put forth preparing for the next game. We ask all the courtesy respect for fellow fans, officials, coaches, those administering the contest, and of course, your team, your opponent. As a board today, members, please respect the game. Now let's meet the team. First, the game on the scoreboard, the Bulldogs of Wood Carroll High School. First, the non-starters, 0, Riley Westall. Number 1, Whitney Passon. Number 2, Tessa Brooks. Number 11, Ashlyn Berta. Number 13, Sylvia Hawn. Number 14, Addison Luke. Number 23, Devin Miller. Number 25, Josie Burr. And number 32, Haley Marga. And now the starting lineup for the Bulldogs. Number 3, Emily Bratton. Number 4, Natalie Lang. Number 5, Charlie Conrad. Number 12, Marissa Wilkinson. Number 21, Emma Sorrell. Number 22, Bulldogs, AJ Ireland. And now let's greet Buckeye Valley's non-starters. Number 1, Keegan McMillan. Number 5, Paige Blue. Number 10, Matt Varsity. Number 12, Lena Wagner. Number 21, Brooklyn Hedges. Number 22, Addison Grant. Number 24, Dakota Fuller. Number 32, Katrina Grizzle. Number 33, MJ Press. Number 44, Shane Fuller. And now the starter for the Mariners of Buckeye Valley. Number 3, Emily Houston. Number 4, Bobby Iyer. Number 11, Marley Osborne. Number 20, Aisley Rector. And number 23, Ella Hazelwood. Good luck with all these. Thank you.
Thank you.
number three. Somebody just gets the 32 seconds.
Good. I got a good friend. Thank you.
Field Carroll, 500 pounds. Melissa Wilkins, recovered 2 seconds.
Thank you.
Emily Houston.
Thank you. Thank you.
the woman's early option.
Thank you. Thank you.
11.
Yeah.
Then we're going out again on 2024 OHSAA Division II District Basketball Tournament Award Ceremony. Please grab your attention to court and join me in congratulating both teams on a competitive and exciting game. First, we will recognize the 2024 OHSAA Division II District Runner-up, the Barons of Buckeye Valley. Presenting the award this evening will be Eric Hughes. Yeah, what a good for the Buckeye Valley. When your name is called, please come forward to receive your individual medallion. Number one, Keegan McMillan. Emily Houston. Molly Meyer. Hey, Blues. Matt Berkey. Marley Osborne. Lena Blackwell. Paisley Blackwell. Addison Graham, Ella Hazelridge, Dakota Keller, Katrina Grizzle, MJ Press. Assistant coach Jeff Weber. Assistant coach Rick Eddington. And the head coach of the American Football Valley, Todd Pennington. Now presenting the district runner-up trophy. Amy Nolan, Class AA representative of the Central District Athletic Board. Head coach Todd Pennington, Eric Seaton, and captains, please come forward to receive your trophy and congratulations on an outstanding season. Ashley Ford. Sister Coach Kyle Lee. Sister Coach Steve Lindbergh. Sister Coach Ron Ireland. Sister Coach Bill Conwell. Your head coach of football, Buck Carroll. Ireland. Now we're going to the trophy once again. The White House of the Central District Award for Andy Nolan. Now, head coach of the Ireland Football Senior Captains, please come forward to the senior trophy. Once again, congratulations to the Bulldogs of Blue Carroll High School, who will now make it to the regional semifinal on Tuesday, March 5th, as Springfield High School celebrates its on behalf of the staff of Springfield High School and the entire high school administration, thank you for attending our game. Remember, please drive home safely.
This week, so it's going to be Ah! understand that you're the junior, is that correct? Yeah. What does it mean to be Division II district champions as a junior?
Really good. I mean, I'm really good.
You certainly are. You earned it, and I'm here for sure tonight. Now, when you think about the junior tournament, what are your initial thoughts there?
I think that if we don't really play hard like we did the past few games,
you're juniors, that means you're upperclassmen. How important is it for you to take a leadership role on this team?
It's very important. We have three great leaders on the team. And then the other juniors are
trying to start the team. I know you started every game this season. Maybe a spot starter here and there. And when you got word that you're going to be starting tonight, what was your favorite?
I was nervous, but I was really excited. Yeah. I was ready.
So, when you think about the legacy that you're leaving here at Lynn Carroll High School, you got a pretty good episode right there,
yeah.
District Championship of Peace and Jewelry. How important is it for you to leave this kind of legacy at Lynn Carroll?
It's really important. I mean, I think it's such a strong
when you think about your senior year at Lynn Carroll High School, what are you thinking?
I'm thinking we have a pretty good team. Our freshman this year.
Yeah, very good. And what's the plans for you after graduating from Carroll?
I'm going to go to college. I'm not sure what I'm going to get. And then
other sports you can play?
No.
This is it. Very good. Talk to me about your family. What do you think
it's for you? My dad is
home. Oh, so is I.
My sister.
Seems like you and I chat a lot after winning pair of ball games, and you know, sometimes we like to spread the love around. You didn't let us do that tonight, and I think that's awesome. 26 points, and you know, you're taking on a team that they have a 6-2 rule, they've got a 5-11 rule, they got a 5-10 rule. What were you thinking at maybe 5-6 or 5-7?
Honestly, we decided to stay solid and box them out and just like.
Yeah, it was a little early. I don't think I'm going to score for the first 2 or 3 minutes of the ball game. What was your mindset going into a contest like this, knowing it's a district championship?
Yeah, so when that's happening, I just have to make sure I get my teammates open more. I trust them.
Half. Coach Bill Barons mentioned that maybe the late rebounds, you'll try to take you out of the game in the third quarter. You scored 8 in the third quarter, 7 and you end up with 26 on the night. I have to tell you what I think are your two best plays tonight. One was in the first half, one was in the second half, and that is taking and staking in charge. Yeah. Because you are going to get hit by somebody bigger than you. Because there aren't very many people smaller than you. And so it's going to be somebody bigger. You find the energy to be willing to stand in there knowing you're going to get fouled over.
Honestly, I just do it for my teammates because I know that's going to pick the energy up. I will sacrifice myself any day for my teammates. I love all of them so much. But yeah, that's really what drives me to take these charges. And it changes the energy of the game. Taking that charge, having that your team's possession in the game.
Well, I'm telling you, after that second one that you took my left from my broadcast position, you bounced up there pretty hard and you stayed. As well, you were pumping up your team because you knew that that moment meant a little bit of transition to, hey, I'm pretty sure we're going to win this thing right here because I just took that charge. Now, when you think about the region, I'm trying to work on your thoughts.
I just know we have to go into that game. I think we played for Salvarian, which they're a really good team. So we just got to go into that game with confidence and just playing really well. So.
Yeah, well, you played extremely well here tonight. Your court vision, I love. The fact that you love to shoot and pass with both hands, I think, is an incredible thing. But I do think you're your best place for making those charges. And that's the kind of leadership that other people will go through and look more for because they know our best player just took a major attack and the charge right there. Really, it's incredible stuff. Congratulations on the victory. Congratulations on making the victory to this champions. It's a great necklace around there. And congratulations on making the victory. Senior with the Grizzly Bar player of the game. Best of luck for the rest of this tournament.
Thank you.
You are welcome. That is Emily Bratton joining us here on the post-game show. And now, the Victorious head coach, A.J. Congratulations. But nobody was playing the Bears and they outside she was 6'3" or 5'11" Well, you know, that's true. And that's the point I made in the pregame show. You know, people like Emily Bratton are like 5'6". She's always played in some of the
home. She played really nice. Yeah, she's not too good. She's long, she's athletic, she's strong, she's basketball.
Yeah, you may have a tweet at your right at the Emma Sorrell in the game. I think she had about 5 or 6 points, but even what an impact player on the defensive side. So good at anticipating the pass. One particular play where she steals the ball, runs the floor, and Bratton finds her on the left pocket, she scores. We got to love that kind of hustle.
That's our team, and that work hard defensively. Get a stop as a team, and then when they come off on the front, they have a good reason. Especially when they're playing with the Carroll, they're going to be back in front of the
team. Their court vision is incredible. She is going to find you if you are open. So, you came into the tonight's contest hoping to get a district championship. You're bringing the trophy back to the district because Fairfield County. I was going to ask you about how that feels.
It feels really, really good. It's been a lot of the years. I feel like the last 3 years, we've come out this year,
you should be. You had some success as a player. You had some success as a coach. And to get to the top of the mountain, which is the district championship game, you got to feel really good about that. We played a lot of players here tonight. People like Miller. I didn't remember playing her name in any of the games that I've covered, and you got to be super excited about that.
Oh, I'm so proud of her. She's the definition of a team player. She waited her time. She was a passing player. She waited her time. She waited her time. She hit the ball off the draft with every single day. We had the most confidence in that. We had the most confidence in that. We saw her every day in practice. We went up against her. We had the same test. We had the same test.
It was a particular play. I think she took a three in the left-hand corner, missed it, came down the other way, ball went out of bounds. So I saw Emily Bratton go to him right away. I don't know what she said right away. But my hunch is she said, hey, now, let's keep playing. Let's keep shooting. Let's keep attacking. We're going to win this thing for crying out loud. So let's stay active. Don't let yourself get down. You can speak to that better.
Yeah, I mean, I'm really proud of you, and especially this second half. I don't see them really. Their leadership has been incredible. She's always been kind of a leader that shows that example. But we really focus on her senior season being a great leader. And that's really up to how she wanted to fly it. We all didn't like the attention too much. But she really stepped it up vocally. And when you have your best player coming and putting that hand around you, we're going to have the confidence to make the next play. So really proud of her.
So your other seniors are Ryan and Wilkinson. A lot of turnover scoring from either one of those tonight, but still providing tremendous leadership. And that has to make it.
I mean, feeling really Christmas is crazy for her. I love it so much. And yeah, I know Mr. Wilkinson didn't score much tonight. She scored a bunch on her last game, but she didn't score much tonight. But she locked up defensively. She handled the ball offensively. She didn't turn it over. She worked hard. I mean, she went back to the command of her spot on that line. She's a stud. He is so good. And Mr. Wilkinson played phenomenal against her. And now Lauren is the best field player I've ever met. I mean, she's just constantly talking. She's so smart. She knows the slider court better than ever actually is. I mean, she's incredible. So it's just so great to meet her.
Number 11, Carly Oswald. Final question. When you think about the regional tournament, what do you think? Okay, you got practice tomorrow. AJ Ireland, congratulations on the Division III District Championship. Best of luck in the regional tournament. You are welcome. And that's AJ Ireland. Join us here on the Post Game Show. Coach Barron, final thoughts on tonight's contest.
Blue Carroll survived in this. They will play Tuesday night, March 5th, at 6 o'clock at Springfield versus a 24-1. First sell Maryland game.
That's who Emily thought they would probably play, and they do. Now, they just beat a 23-2 Buckeye Valley Lady Barron's team, so maybe they feel like we're in pretty good shape. We'll turn the lights on. We should probably head out of here. You did a great job on this broadcast tonight. I really appreciate it, and let's do this again sometime soon. That will wrap it up from Central Crossing High School. Our next broadcast will be on Tuesday night, as we'll be covering these Blue Carroll Lady Bulldogs, and we're going to cover as many Fairfield County teams as possible throughout this tournament time, because we are your source for Fairfield County High School sports. We are the Fairfield County Sports Network, and you check our Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook accounts to find where we'll be and who will be covering all basketball tournament season long. For Coach Bill Behrens, I'm Steve Rau, where the Boone Carroll Lady Bulldogs improve their record to 20-5, and the Buckeye Valley Lady Barons see their season come to a close at 23-3, as the Boone Carroll Lady Bulldogs are Division II District Champions by defeating the Buckeye Valley Lady Barons by a final score of 49-36. Until more tournament basketball on Tuesday night here on the network. Good evening, everyone.
There was traffic here, but the first game, the beginning of the first game, there was no game to court.
Okay. I was thinking this like before.
I think they've been cleaned up here. They have events here every weekend.
Oh, okay.
That was
big.
My knee traffic.
Came up with you.
Purcell Marion has like the number one girl in the country.
Do they?
Yep.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, that should be fun, huh?
They should enjoy this.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Emily, when she stepped down, she's like, yeah, I might just skip the next game.
Yeah, it was fun while it lasted, right?
Oh, yeah. I'm glad they got this one.
But other than that, they don't have anything going for them. Having the number one
they're
player.
They're pretty.
No, they got plenty. Yeah.
Did they smoke after something?
You don't get the number one player in the country without having a team, right?
Pretty. They smoked them last year, and then they beat them again this year.
Yeah,
it was a closer game this year, but they, yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah, Afrocentric. If Afrocentric can't beat them, then
I don't know. Yeah, that's a tall order, isn't it?
That'll be like Buster Douglas beating Mike Tyson. So.
They got plenty of players. It's not just the one
NBA
player. They got plenty
like
to 65.
Go. How big are they?
They're not all as tall except for like D and I think maybe a couple other players. But their guards are like really quick and they can all shoot and with D like facilitating and like running the offense and everything.
Yeah, it's been lost.
They're really tough.
I gotta get another one made. I keep forgetting about it. Because I have that.
They play really fast too. I don't know how fast like Boone Carroll can play, but it's going to be.
I've been the bad luck for them for 5 years now.
Oh, really?
They've only won. Seen them win one time.
Did you do internet?
Oh, wow.
Who have you seen them against? He wants to see them against good teams.
Saw them play Circleville the freshman year. That was a loss. Circleville was going to do that year. Saw them play London the freshman year. They lost that game. Saw them play now Winchester. Saw
see you, gentlemen.
See you. All right, have a good night.
Saw them play now. They beat them in sophomore year.
I think Lancaster Gyms will be very similar.
Saw them lose to Dexley in the District Cities last year. Saw them lose to Circleville this year. Saw them lose to Granville in the District Finals in sophomore year. So, like, 1-5.
I didn't realize you've seen them that many times.
Yeah, I've gone out. Yeah, I've watched her at least twice a year.
I saw her in a tournament game like a couple years ago, I think. And then I saw her last year, I think once. I can't remember who it was against. Oh, it was Logan. I've seen her against Logan, I think, twice. That's probably why I haven't seen her lose. Because okay. I go watch them play Logan. I mean, trying to get highlights, bro. I felt bad for London Johnson today at Canal Winchester. She was dominating the whole game and didn't get like much of any help until like late in the fourth quarter. And she started the game scoring like 12 of her first 14 points or something. She's only a sophomore. I was telling Emma, it's like, it's crazy. All the good girls teams, like at least D1, like, they're all young. Like, extremely young. They've got, like, no seniors almost that really play.
Yeah, it's
like, all in Tangi
right now. Like,
yeah.
All
in Tangi is freshman and sophomore. Sophie Zeal is a junior. She's back next year. Now Winchester is young. Harvest Prep, they didn't play today, obviously, but Harvest Prep has, like, their entire team is based on the sophomores. And then, who else? Peck Central is pretty young, too, outside of, like, Barry Wallace, really. So, all these teams are about to be good for the next, like, 3 years, if not longer. took our first time and posted it. I don't really care. Yeah, I was like, I don't really care. It's funny. It's funny, but I don't really care. And welcome to the cold world. It was cool being with some of my guys today. Coop, Nick, Mark.
Deep.
Yeah, we're going pretty deep today.
Deals.
D.O. to D.O.
I saw a lot of knees in the neck.
This is the Sony one, right?
Yeah, I'll film a high school game. I'll use the same battery all year pretty much. I'll film a high school game, and I'll have like 74% left.
I went through basically two full ones. The third one didn't really get a lot of usage. If I switched to the third one at halftime of the last game, and I really didn't film that much after halftime.
That was what I did. North Union last night. I looked at the stop at halftime. It was 51-18.
Yeah, I almost never make games like that. Or I can stop at.
I've been getting, that's all the games that I had, like a streak. In the regular season, bro, every game I got was a banger. And then the last, excluding today, the last like 7 minutes blowout. I thought North Union was better than the Joe's.
Never seen it. And that CBC must be trash. I'm pretty sure it is. I don't know what.
Yeah, we're about to head up.
They had to have some good ones, though, right?
To get a 2-seed?
Yeah, what? To get a 2-seed, they would have had to beat somebody decent, right?
They were like 17-5. Yeah, I don't know.